In this video, we're going to be looking at the landmarks of the scapula. Here we have a right scapula, so that means it comes from the right side of the body, and we're looking at the posterior side. We know that this is the posterior side because we see this very long ridge of bone running obliquely across the scapula. This is called the spine of the scapula. The spine of the scapula is an important landmark, and you can actually feel it on your own back. If you reach around and touch your shoulder blade, your scapula, you should feel that ridge running across the back of it. It's important for us in anatomy because it's going to allow us to find our next three structures. So above the spine of the scapula, we have this depressed area. So you can see how my fingers slide into it. It's kind of like a little basin or depression. Since this depression sits above the spine, it's superior to the spine, we're going to call it the supraspinous fossa. Supra means above, spinous refers to the spine, and fossa means depression. Below the spine, we have the infraspinous fossa. Infra means inferior or below, spinous refers to the spine, and fossa means depression. The supraspinous fossa serves as the attachment site for the supraspinatus muscle, while the infraspinous fossa serves as the attachment site for the infraspinatus muscle. If we go back to our spine and we follow it up, we see that it flattens out and forms this high point. So when we look at the scapula, we can see that this point is the highest point on the scapula. This is called the acromion. Akros in Greek means high, omos means shoulder. So acromion literally means high point of the shoulder. This is also where our clavicle is going to articulate. Now we're going to turn this scapula to look at the lateral side of it. So as we turn the bone, now we're looking at the side that points out towards the upper limb. Here we can see our acromion, and notice how below the acromion we have this depressed area. This is the glenoid cavity or glenoid fossa. The glenoid cavity or glenoid fossa serves as the socket in the ball and socket joint that forms the shoulder. In fact, the word glene in Greek means socket, so glenoid is socket shaped. Above our glenoid, we have this kind of weirdly shaped process that sticks out. This is called the coracoid process, coracoid. Now, corax in Greek means crow. And so if you look at this projection, here's the head of the crow, and then here's the beak of the crow. You can kind of see it does look like a bird's head. Now, one thing that first-time anatomy students often do is they confuse the terms coronoid with coracoid. Coronoid means hook-shaped. Coracoid means shaped like a crow. The way I remember this is coracoid with a C is on the scapula, because scapula has a C, scapula doesn't have an N. Now, this was the back. This was where the spine of the scapula was. We're going to turn it around and look at the anterior surface. So this is the surface that sits up against the rib cage. Notice this very large depression on the front side of our scapula. This is the subscapular fossa. Sub means below, so this is below the scapula. It's on the front side. Our subscapularis muscle attaches here. Now, two more features that we need to mention on our scapula are the borders. Along this border, we call this the medial border. So this edge points towards our spinous process of our vertebral column. It kind of looks like the blade of an axe, which is where we get the term shoulder blade from. This border over here is the lateral border. The lateral border has the glenoid cavity attached to it, or glenoid fossa. Lateral means that it points out away from the body.